Hey everybody, welcome back to Twinkle Tunes and Lighting. Today, I'm gonna show you how to build this. It's one of my favorite gadgets that I created. It's my LED tester. It's wireless, it's battery operated, and it's controlled by WLED. Stick around, I'll show you how to do it. Let's go. We'll begin with the power supply, which not only powers the system, but also charges the rechargeable 12-volt lithium-ion battery pack. A Y adapter then connects the battery in parallel with the GLED Opto. If the external power supply is removed, the battery seamlessly takes over, ensuring continuous 12-volt operation of the entire setup. For a 5-volt system, we introduce a buck converter between the battery and the GLED Opto to step the voltage down from 12 volts to 5 volts. Once connected, the GLED Opto distributes regulated power to the lighting system. And if the external power supply is removed, the battery seamlessly takes over, maintaining a stable 5-volt operation across the entire setup. So here's a list of materials: an Apache 550 case, 12-volt DC pigtails, two females and one male, lighting tails, I use the Reiwu, a buck converter, that's only if you're making the 5-volt version of this, and a GLED Opto. Three PG7 glands. And a 12-volt lithium-ion rechargeable battery. All right, let's roll up the old Twinkle Tunes and Lighting mat so we can see things a little bit better. I took the case here and I already put three holes in it. These are half-inch size holes because this is what the PG7 gland requires. Once when I put the PG7 gland in, I go ahead and screw that down. It has a rubber grommet on it and it goes ahead and seals right in there. These are the cables I'm using. I put ferro connectors on the end of it. I use a Reiwu connection. All my stuff is all Reiwu, so those are my Reiwu tails. So whatever tails you use, you're gonna put your tails in there, whether it's X-Connect or if you wanna just do something else, that's fine as well. Here's my battery pack. Again, I put some 3M double side stick tape on there. I'm gonna go ahead and mount the GLED Opto on top of the battery pack so it all is kind of in one place here. And so now that I've got that mounted, the 3M adhesive tape is the best tape that's out there. I've tried them all, this is the best. We're gonna go ahead and get our cables prepped here. We're gonna strip all those back, strip our DC cables back. We're gonna start tinning the corners, tinning the inputs and outputs, tinning our cables. So there's a digital version of the buck converter, and there's also a standard version like this that's a non-digital. They both connect exactly the same. They're both buck converters. They both take your DC power and take it down from whatever voltage you have and put it to whatever voltage you want. Here I am, I'm soldering from the top down. It makes my cables nice and neat that go through the connection here. Once I get those soldered in, I take my flush cuts and cut off the end, and I have a nice professional looking end on there. On there, I went ahead and I put the female end on the buck converter because that's what we're going to need to plug into the GLED Opto. Put some double-sided tape on here, taped it to the top of the battery, and I'm going to go ahead and start terminating the other ends here. So you can see one end is coming through the gland and one end that's hanging loose. That is my input side, so that's 12 volts coming in. I'm going to go ahead and terminate that on top of the buck converter, and I have the other cable ready to plug into the battery. Now my buck converter here, you can see that now I'm starting to adjust it. So there's a little set screw that's in the buck converter, and as you take a tiny screwdriver and you turn it to the left, it drops the output voltage to whatever voltage you want. I desire to have a 5-volt output, and so that's what I'm doing. I'm spinning that screw to the left until I get exactly 5 volts. And there you have it. If you have the digital version, obviously the digital readout tells you what it is. And so this is the standard version. These are a little bit cheaper, a little bit easier to work with. And I have a digital one that I'll show you later in the video. That works out great. A couple pieces of double-sided stick tape on this as well. I'm gonna attach the battery to the bottom of the case so it doesn't move around. I'm gonna take the 12 volt, the Y splitter up there, put the 12 volt into the battery, and therefore it'll charge and also run the buck converter at the same time. The other side of the buck converter that's having 5 volts out, I'm gonna put that into the GLED Opto. So now my Opto is 5 volts output. Terminate my two Reiwu connections, and here we go, let's give it a test. I've used the app and I've populated the GLED Opto, and I think I populated probably 30 lights, 30 LEDs. You can see there they are, they're populated. They've come up, it's powered up. We're gonna go into the app here and actually make sure I have control of the Opto. And there you go, I got my blues, my greens, my reds, everything works. And so we're talking wirelessly to the GLED Opto and it's working. Now I'm gonna show you how to build the 12 volt version of this. But before I go on, I gotta give credit where credit is due. This is my buddy, Nate Dursteller. He is a wonderful lighting director. He is a great lighting designer. And this summer we got to work on a couple of projects together. And one of those projects were actually putting some lighting elements in the middle of a field with no power and no infrastructure. And he kind of came up with this idea of let's make some battery packs and see if we can get the LEDs to work. And he came up with this idea and I took it home. I actually changed a few of the elements to where I could get it to work like a tester. And so I thank Nate for that, and it was a great idea. So shout out to Nate Dursteller out there. The difference between the 5 volt and the 12 volt is this little piece here. It's just a simple DC splitter. And so I go into the GLED Opto and I go into the battery pack. And so when it's plugged into the wall, it will not only power up the GLED Opto, it also charges the battery through the GLED Opto. Now that I've got my tester configured, ready to go, we're gonna come outside here. Let's check on a couple of props, make sure they're working properly. I like to bring my tester and also like to bring small extension, makes it a little bit easier to plug things in. Let me show you how it works. So here I have one of my props, it's my skull. It's 20 LEDs. So let's go ahead and get the tester out and let's make sure all 20 LEDs are working. I'm gonna go ahead and open up my tester. I'm gonna flip on the battery on the backside here. I'm showing that I'm reading 5 volts. That's what these props are, so it's 5 volts. It's ready to go. And I've already configured the inside and the WLED to spit out, I don't know, probably 100 lights or 50 lights, something like that. But it's way more than what we need for this. But it's gonna go ahead and light it all up so we can see it. So then I've got my tester here, got my extension on now. And then we're gonna go ahead and plug in the back here. Just make sure it all works here. There we go. Got all 20 lights working. Super easy, super simple concept, running off of a battery. You can take it anywhere you want to in your show and test all your props. Since this controller is controlled by WLED, I can pull out my phone and pull out the app, and I can actually test it in all different kinds of ways. There's my reds, my blue, there's my green. But that's the great thing about it. You can control it with your phone, you can control it with the app, and there's no wires attached to it. It's fantastic. Let's go check another prop, see how that works out. So here's another prop. This is gonna be one of my tombstones. It's 150 LEDs, and we're gonna test it with the checker here. There we go. So we can see it's populated for 150. I've got it going on a chase. Let's look at the app, and we're gonna go back to solid here and make sure that all our colors are working. So here's my green, there's my red. I mean, there's my blue, there's my red. So now we can see that it's all working. It's such a great tool to have, especially when you are up on a ladder trying to check some of these things and you don't have time to run a cable up there or anything else. You just grab your checker that you built and send it up there. Pretty handy. So because these things are controlled by WLED and they're wireless, I can actually get them programmed into xLights and have them controlled by xLights. And so that's another really cool feature. So if you want to put a controller in a remote location, you don't want to run wires to it, or perhaps you want to put it on a float or on your car or any, you know, basically anywhere you want to, you can use these and they last a really long time because they're only powering some LEDs. And so let me show you a couple places where I'm running my extra controllers without any wires to it and see what you think. But one of the places that I have it controlling some of my lights are next to one of my other controllers here. Because it's wireless, I can put it anywhere I want to. But it's up here on the wall. It's underneath one of my controllers that are controlling some of my props. But this one here, that one controls my LED bars, the ones that I built. They're 12 volt and it works great. Because you have the option of either running it with a battery or you have the option of plugging it in and then charging the battery and running it at the same time, it works perfect for any application that you want. Pretty cool, I like it. Hey, thanks so much for watching. Make sure you guys like and subscribe to Twinkle Tunes and Lighting for more tips and tricks. If you guys have built one of those, let me see your projects. Let me see what you're working on. And also, if you guys have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next one. It really is a cool thing. I don't know, I like it. I can test all this stuff. I got a bunch of crap around here. I don't even know what works.